Welcome back to You Special on NDTV Hindu. We are discussing, is consumerism eating us up? Now, in the want for many things around us, like mobile phones, laptops, our parents are under a lot of pressure. Now, when one person wants something because he sees a better model or a better laptop in another's hand, is that a kind of imitation? Okay, I want this like him. Why don't you start with some comments?
Yeah, because of that, we are becoming more luxurious. We have our own demands that has to be fulfilled. If parents, people are going to bad habits, they are stealing money and such stuff they are doing, and they are deteriorating their health as well. So these aspects, I support that parents should keep limit.
A tab, yeah.
Yeah,
maybe a limit on
yeah.
how much he can give. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you have another point?
Yes, of course. About consumerism, what I say is that we should not only think about us, but we should also think about other things. Because, for example, you take America, extreme consumerism in America has caused recession. The entire world is suffering because of that. There is recession, you know, they keep on spending. They don't have money. Then also, you know, they'll take credit cards and they'll spend. What is the effect? The end term, maybe they were happy for some time, but then now everybody is suffering. And the countries who are suffering, it's like countries like us. It's like people like us who are suffering. So whenever we bring a topic such as consumerism, we should think holistically about everything that comes. Because whenever there is suffering for the people in general.
All right.
People who are lagging behind. So we have to think about them also. It's not... We just cannot live by thinking about ourselves only.
All right. Now, in this whole aspect of consumerism, let's also get in some distractions that we have in our life. For instance, you know, a Farmville or a Mafia Wars. Once upon a time, we had an outdoor game, maybe like a throwball or a Marco Polo, whatever it may be. But today, youth, like you and me, are glued to the internet playing Mafia Wars or harvesting your farm. Is that a kind of distraction? You're missing out on things,
yeah,
better things of life?
It is a distraction, because I want to give you one example. One of my friend, every day she'll make sure that she'll go to Farmville and Petville just to feed her dog, to buy her stuff and everything. She's not spending time with the friends, and she'll go with the, she'll tell that I have a work, I have to go to Facebook and
yeah.
do my feed my pet. And every day she'll give the status also in the Facebook that I have bought this thing for my dog and everything.
So in that
so everything,
yeah.
every all the youth are being, you know, addicted to Facebook
yes.
and Mafia Wars and everything.
All right.
But I don't think so, it's a good.
So are you saying the technology, why don't you pass it to that gentleman there? Technology and the kind of consumerism here in the world today, in India at least, is eating us up away from the reality?
Actually, consumerism is not eating us up. When we talk about this Farmville and these sort of things, if we think about the marketing view of this, these companies are like giving employment to people, are helping people out, and they are like providing a source of enjoyment and entertainment for other people. And it is like if these things were not there, then it is always the choices available for people.
Mm-hmm.
They can obviously go for outdoor games. They can now go for these sort of games also, because these things will definitely help in technological advancements.
Right.
And you can say the more creativity and the more innovation as it comes, it will lead to progress.
All right. So we've got a point saying, okay, there is business, there is marketing, but it's the individual to blame for falling into this trap. You have a point? You want to counter
yeah,
that?
Yeah, it's like I want to support Vibhu in this motion. These days, social networking sites are coming up. So it should be like accepted as a platform of social making networks with people to grow up personally and professionally and also socially. Now, coming back to the thing of mafia wars and all, it's we need to address the change in times. And with a fast-paced world, when people are having their own agenda, there's hardly any time left for socializing. Supposedly, if I have to meet a friend who stays in Anandnagar, I have to think, oh God, like whether I'll be able to catch up with that person or not.
So convenience is also what matters.
It's convenience also what matters.
All right, she wants to counter that. Can you pass the phone? Abhishek Bachchan says, use your fingers on the mobile phone, save up on exercise. Are we losing out on exercise, basic exercise? You wanted to counter her point?
Yeah, I wanted to counter her point. You're telling it's a way of social networking. I addressed that. But the thing is, Farmville and Mafia Wars, I don't find a point there. I used to play Farmville and Mafia Wars. At one point, they asked for credit cards. They ask you to pay money so that you can play further. So your kids, what, they come and ask you, like, I want credit cards so that I can buy two guns? What is Mafia Wars? They're
okay.
telling you that I want to kill so many people so I can get this much of score. You have so many other ways of networking. You have mails, you have phones.
All right, so are we being consumed by all of this technology.
Yes, of course. I just want to ask one question to her, countering her point that being glued to your computer for hours and hours, and you say that you're creating a social network, what about you go out and pass a smile to two people instead, utilizing that same time? So don't you think that's better networking out there?
Mm-hmm. All right, so you're saying it's just going back to old times, doing something as simple as going out and socializing with people instead of doing that on the internet.
Yes, of course. You spend all of your time just glued to the computer. You don't go and interact with people. How will you develop your interpersonal skills?
All right.
I don't think so. It is of any use. Facebook, they're just eating away your time.
All right, that's okay. We're just concentrating on one aspect there. But these are the one of the many other distractions. We're talking about internet. But also coming into the getting the consumerism and the consumption point of view. Do you believe if you have the money, might as well spend it?
I want to tell you one thing. Now kids, they don't go and play. Mm-hmm. They just go at home and do Facebook or cooking and all.
Yeah.
I just want to say the exercise part is going off. Like, everybody is sitting and just on the laptops. They're having eye problems, back problems, but still they are sitting on the and doing the Facebooking thing and all.
All right. Pass it on. Yeah.
Okay. I support her for this. As in people, that health concerns are also rising just because of this networkings and all. And the main point is people are getting emotionally attached also.
Mm-hmm.
As how Vidhi ma'am said, that it's like something, some people are just attached with, except going out and socializing. They're mm-hmm. like more into, have to feed my dog, which is not real.
Mm-hmm.
And that's causing something, even if they ask you to pay for that, you are ready to do that okay. because you are emotionally attached.
Okay, so things like this take you away from your friends, family. Why don't you pass the microphone to that gentleman there? There was also an advertisement recently about this little boy who says, at 18, I want to buy this car. And when I'm a CEO, I want to buy a higher end version of the car. It's all about I want, I want. That's what the youth of today are saying.
Need, wants and demands.
Mm-hmm. There's a difference?
Yeah, that's the thing. Because the small boy, right at the age of 8 or 9, he says he wants the thing at the level of CEO. So he has made up his mind that he has to be a CEO at one point of time in his life.
What if he goes up to his dad and says, I want this?
See, he's saying that when he'll become a CEO, he will get that car.
So you're saying it's his aim and not what he really demands?
His aim and vision. His aim and vision has been grown high.
Okay.
Like, it's not like that I'm going to pass this test, I'm going to pass that test.
All right.
It's like going...
All right, you made your point. Pass the mic to her, please. You want to counter that? All right. Tell me why you want to counter that.
Because the advertisement starts with that when I'm at the age of 18, I want it. It's not saying a designation on something that I'll be this and I'll be doing this. I want to add a statistics to this that only 1.5% of all available resources in the world, according to the World Bank, is being used by the people who are below poverty line. All those 98.5% are being used as a consumerism.
All right, with that point, I think I'll have to wrap up this segment. We want to explore some more possibilities. I will give you all a chance. We'll have to wrap this segment. We're going to discuss whether we really save in all this habitual spending. That's coming up on the other side. Do stay with us.